Tony. So you alluded to, you touched upon this, but you didn't quite go there. I'm going to go there. When I think about Urban Meyer, and I try to put it in perspective, and the perspective from just about any angle is the guy just coached his, well, I almost went to a literal analogy there. He just achieved at an insane rate like he did at his previous stops. Okay, but when I think about Urban Meyer's tenure, unfortunately, I think about the near misses, that it was, he was this close to just having an insane level of success.
Well, and it starts in 2012 when he arrived and they go 12-0 but can't play in a bowl game because of the 2011 bowl game. And then he wins, 24 games in a row, and you lose to Michigan State in the 2013 Big Ten Championship game, one game away from playing for a national title. And, you know, but like Steve said, it's so difficult. Now, it's almost to the point where it's like college basketball, where I don't think you can expect a team to win a national title. You can't expect – those are unrealistic expectations because it's a six-game tournament. You have to be hot, you know, for at least the last four games. And college football isn't quite there yet, but it's so much more difficult than one bowl game to decide it all. And when you're playing in a Big Ten championship game or a conference championship game, you're not playing a joke team. Even that Michigan State team in 2013 had a heck of a defense. And, you know, the 2015 Michigan State game, a couple weeks ago on Twitter, I put out a poll of asking Buckeye fans which was the most painful Michigan State loss, be it the 98 or the 2013 or the 2015 game. And just the fact that Michigan State is as so many of those in that 2015 game, that was the winner of the poll, but that 2015 team still, I they were fat and happy. They were a satisfied bunch. They were looking forward to the NFL. And so I think,
and they kind of got what they deserved enough to go 12-1 and finish number three in the country.
Exactly. And despite the disinterest, they were right there. And One bad defensive lapse in that game away from, you know, going and repeating, basically.
We're not blaming it on the weather.
it was miserable down there, Steve will tell you, I'll tell you.
I know.
It was not fun down there on the sidelines, and I was only down there for a few minutes. So,
I'm going to play devil's advocate and let whomever wants to chime in. It's almost going to be much better here if I just sit back and let you guys just talk Ohio State football again. I truly believe that. But Tony, I'm going to play devil's advocate, and your points are all well taken about how difficult it is to win a national championship. But we've got 130 teams in the FBS. We've got 70 in the Power Five. We've got roughly, I don't know, depending on how you view it, 8 to 12 that could win a national championship realistically any given year. Isn't there still one team that wins the national championship? So the odds are still the same.
Yeah, one team is going to do it, but it's a longer road, and it's more difficult in the past than in the past. Somebody has to win it, yes. Just like any tournament, somebody has to win it. But, you know, but I say that, and yet Alabama and Clemson, they're always there, you know, always, at least in the last, you know, few years, and always is a relative term. But if two teams can always get there, three teams should always be able to get there as well. You know, so you can't, on one hand, I'm kind of, you know, talking out of both sides of my mouth here, where it's difficult, but other teams don't make it look so difficult.
Clemson this year's got the team that's capable of being the first team to repeat as the playoff champion, I think. And that's something we have not seen yet in this playoff era, is with these extra layers for the Big Ten, a conference championship, and then a national semifinal, and then a national championship. That hurdle is so big that it takes you a full year to get over the fact that you won the national championship the year before. It was like when they won it in 2014, the calendar shifted to 2015 for everybody else in the country, but for Ohio State, they were stuck in 2014. And I think it was hard for the Ohio State staff to motivate, you know, the guys like Elliott or Bosa, or, you know, maybe they're not even the best examples, but maybe some of the other guys on that team who thought that they had, you know, had made it when in fact they really hadn't. I mean, it was a team that was led by those guys I mentioned and JT Barrett and other guys. You know, it just didn't come together in 2015. And that's what we've seen for Alabama and Clemson as they've traded it back and forth. The following year has been just an uphill climb. And Clemson now has that thing around its neck that try and defend it, because it's not an easy thing. No one's repeated in the playoff era. Alabama did repeat in the BCS era before this went the other direction, but it's become so much tougher, I think, as Tony said, the climb to the top is what is so strenuous and arduous.
I don't even think anyone has been able to even be ranked number one in the beginning of the season and continued to go on and then win the national championship.
That may be a good point.
My guess is Florida State in 2013 would have been the last. That's a guess.
Ohio State certainly wasn't. It either never happened or only maybe happened a handful of times.
Oh, yeah. It's very difficult to do.